Larry again. I promised I'd show you how to overcome your fears and doubts. And here it is, directly from my course, Sail Into Retirement. By watching this, you're seeing it right out of the course itself. This is the real deal. So watch this following video.
If I were to ask you what the scariest moment in your life was, could you tell me? Take a moment just to picture that in your mind. For many of you, I happen to know the answer was learning to ride a bicycle. Can you imagine that the scariest moment of one's life was learning to ride a bike? Maybe it was so scary because we were kids when we first rode a bike. But even if this was the scariest moment in your life, isn't that false expectations appearing real? The definition of fear? If you were to ask me the same question, the answer might surprise you. It wasn't dodging pirates in the Gulf of Aden, which we did. It wasn't being chased by Komodo dragons in Indonesia, which we were. And it wasn't even battling the worst storm of our lives in the middle of the Red Sea. Can you believe that none of these were the scariest moment of my life? The scariest moment of my life was sailing out underneath the Golden Gate Bridge as I made that life-altering decision to abandon my identity. So imagine how scary that must have been to trump the fear of being caught in this storm. My two-man crew and I had been caught in the exact wrong place at the wrong time in the middle of the Red Sea. It was a storm that came 24 hours early, and its strength was way underestimated. Imagine our small boat flying off the top of a 30-foot wave and slamming down into the trough below, shaking and shuddering like a cannon. The seas were not only huge, but they were steep, and they were coming fast. I remember counting 1,001, 1,002, 1,003, and bam, another one would hit us. It was exhausting. All I really wanted to do was go down below, crawl into a bunk, pull the covers up over my eyes, and wish it all away. But then I looked at my crew, and I saw their eyes were as wide as saucers with fear. They were scared. And me? Was I scared? Well, I wouldn't exactly use that word, as I think the word terrified is more appropriate. You'd have to be crazy not to be scared under those conditions. The fear was definitely founded. I was afraid for myself, for the boat, and most of all, for my crew. But fear, like most emotions, is contagious. And I was the captain, the leader, and the last thing I needed was a crew frozen with fear that they saw in me. I needed my crew to do their job for the overall safety of the boat. I needed to inspire confidence, motivation, and passion. And it didn't matter how rough it was. I didn't have any choice but to lead. So if I was terrified, how did I get through my fears right then? We all know that fear causes one of two reactions, fight or flight. So I checked to see if there were any flights going out of the middle of the Red Sea that morning. Okay, not really, but it did cross my mind. But our only choice was to stay and fight, and to learn about fear. And I learned a lot about fear that day. I learned that fear is nature's way of making us focus on the task at hand. It sharpens your senses, and it makes you more alert. And you can use that fear to your advantage right then and there. So in this lesson, you're going to learn how to use fear to your advantage. Well, it's natural to be afraid when stepping out of your comfort zone as you work toward your goals. It's something you haven't done before, or it's a new venture. And your mind can take you places of fear rather than inspiration. In fact, everybody is motivated twice as much to move away from that which you fear than you are toward what you want. Fear is that strong. So consequently, it's no surprise that Fear often rules the day. Well, that all changes for you from this moment on. Because any fears you may have about taking your next big step beyond business, beyond your professional career, are no longer in charge. The fears are no longer in charge. From now forward, you will use fear to your advantage. It's not all that difficult. And there are really only two steps to learning to use fear to your advantage. The first step is to recognize that you're afraid. You've felt and seen fear. If you had been with us that day in the Red Sea, you would have seen my palms sweating, my eyes bright and darting all around, my muscles all pumped up, and you could have heard my heart beating through my chest from 3 feet away. Does any of this sound familiar? Think back to your scary moment. You'll remember the same signs, even if it was you riding a bicycle as a kid. When you recognize the fear, you may have also noticed that it's making you more focused. It's making your senses sharper. You're more alert to what's going on around you. And this is nature's way of arming you with higher senses for the fight or flight. Believe me, when I was at the wheel in 30-foot seas, I was focused, sharp, and alert. And while I was still afraid, I was a better performer. So this naturally occurring phenomena is indeed a gift. When it arrives, recognize it. The next step is in using fear to your advantage. It's just a little bit trickier. You must accept and embrace that you're afraid. Yes, you heard me right. Accept and even embrace the fear. By taking this important step, you disarm the fear. You take away its power when you say to yourself, okay, I'm afraid. Now, instead of letting it freeze me up, as in freeze and frozen, since I know the benefits that fear can give me, I'm going to let it in. And then you can embrace what the fear is doing for you. It's making you focused, it's making you sharper, and it's making you more alert. And you can, right there and then, on the spot, use those newfound powers to your advantage. I like to think of fear as that little red devil that sits on your shoulder. You know, it's the bad guy who tells you to have that third cocktail or the fourth cookie or the second bowl of ice cream. And when you recognize and embrace the fear, it's basically like saying to the fears, well, you can come along for the ride, you can sit on the shoulder if you want, but you no longer have any say in what I feel or how I act. I know you're there, and I know you're trying to do bad things, but I know better. Larry told me that you could do good things for me. So there, you're not the boss of me and no longer rule the day. Don't listen to the wind as it howls through the rigging. It's always trying to scare you. Just get back behind the wheel and start steering. So go to the digital action guide and write down one thing you're afraid of. Just one thing. Under that, write the three elements that make you afraid of that one thing. For example, my fear was crossing the ocean. Well, elements that make up that fear were the three elements that I came up with. Number one was losing sight of land. Number two was big storms that could happen in the middle of the ocean. And number three was running out of food. So next, after you've identified those three elements, provide the logical answer to those fears. I mean, logical, you know, not false expectations appearing real. Logical answer to those fears. So, for me, losing sight of land. Well, it's actually safer out at sea than it is near shore. A not-so-famous sailor named Jacobson once said, "It's not the ocean that gets you, it's the hard bits around the edges." You know, most boats get into trouble when they're close to land, not at sea. Okay, now, what about big storms in the middle of the ocean? Well, most of the time, you can see storms coming on satellite weather pictures. And preparation and training with my crew on, you know, what actions we should take during bad weather really helped me manage my fears. And then my third fear was running out of food. Well, it turns out you can always fish for food. And we did, and we caught enough fish that could have kept us going basically forever. So now it's your turn to complete the activity in your digital action guide.